pleased, but pretty pleased with the cherry on top game.
Hey YouTube, and welcome back to another video. Today, we are going to be talking about how to dominate the early game in Fortnite. A few weeks ago, I sent out a poll asking you all what video topics you like to see, and the second most requested topic was surviving the early game. So today, due to popular demand, I'm going to be going over some tips I always try to keep in the back of my head to help me survive the early game. As a heads up, these tips I give are part of a process and are really good habits more than anything else that will help you come out on top in the early game. The goal of this video isn't to make you suddenly a perfect aim or turn you into an insane builder. Rather, this video will give you an idea of how you should be making decisions in the early game, and that's going to help you regardless of your mechanical skill. As always, I have timestamps below in the description of the video that sort of outline what I'm going to be talking about, and with those you can jump between different sections of the video as you like. Okay, with all that said, let's talk about some key tips you can use to help you dominate the early game. Alright, so the first thing you have to be thinking about in order to succeed in the early game is picking a good drop spot. This topic alone could take up a whole video, but for the sake of time, I'll list a few things I plan out when picking a drop spot. Firstly, if my goal is to win, I always try to pick a drop spot I'm comfortable with. I talked about this a little in my How to Loot Faster video, but there are a number of advantages that come from dropping somewhere you're familiar with. To list just a couple, you're going to be able to move around the area faster if you know it well, you're going to be able to loot faster, and you'll be able to predict where other players are going to be located in that area. If every game you're dropping into a new location, it's going to be really hard for you to succeed in the early game because you'll be looting slower and you won't know where players are, and on top of all that, you'll have to spend a lot of time figuring out the location instead of actually spending that time doing things that are going to give you a better chance at winning. Of course, if you want to go tour the map, have at it, but if your goal really is to win, try to familiarize yourself with a few locations around the map and then plan on dropping there so that you'll always have somewhere you're comfortable going to. Secondly, with picking a good drop spot, you have to pick somewhere that both has a lot of loot and that also has relatively low players. The reality is, dropping at Tilted Towers is rarely ever going to work out. But at the same time, dropping Junk Junction every game isn't very fun either. So you want to look for locations that offer a good player count and loot balance. If you're going for the win and you want a relatively active game where you aren't just camping in the corner of the map to get to top 10, I would recommend going to a large town that has around 3 to 4 players at max. You want other players there for a couple of reasons. Of course you want to fight people, but you also want them to help you loot by getting loot and then giving it to you when you kill them later. The goal should be to loot for a few minutes and then engage with 1 or 2 people in your starting town and then leave with enough meds and mats to be set for the rest of the game. For me, my thought process that I find works well when I'm looking at the map at the start of the game and deciding where I want to drop, as I try to look at the second half of the bus's route and then drop at a town that's 1 or 2 towns located away from that. I do this because usually people want to jump out of the bus right away, so if you're a little more patient, you can still drop into a big town like Retail Row or Paradise Palms and benefit from all the loot there, but you won't have to deal with the players that might usually come with these towns if they were at the start of the battle bus route. Every game is going to be different, and sometimes you might just get unlucky to have 10 people drop to your town when you thought there would only be 3, but if you follow these dropping guidelines, you'll be able to reduce that random factor and put yourself in a better position for the early game. Okay, now that you've picked a smart drop spot, let's talk about what you should be doing as you drop. I know this has been repeated time and time again, but when you are dropping, you want to get as low to the ground as possible so you can be the first one down. This is a pretty simple step, so I won't dwell on it too much, but try to use your map to get as low as possible before you pull your glider. That way you can drop first and have a little bit of a head start on the rest of the people in your town. Also, while you're dropping, you want to be scanning the air to see where other people are going to land. This step is really important and shouldn't go overlooked because a lot of the reason you are going to die in the early game is due to a lack of information. More than anything else, I'd say, I die in the early game because I get randomly shot when I don't expect it, so it's really important that in the early game, you know where people are around you, and you kind of have an idea of where to look for people in the town, so that way you aren't snuck up on or caught off guard. If you don't know the town well and you don't know where people are, you're going to be a sitting duck, and it's going to be really hard to have success in early game fights. For that reason, I would honestly recommend that after you loot your first house or building, you should probably use third person to peek around the town and try to scan before you go out and start moving around. That way you can get around safely and limit those random deaths that come from getting jumped out of nowhere. Now that you've dropped to a good spot and know where people are around you, you need to come up with a game plan for how you want to take fights. One of the most common pitfalls I run into in the early game is taking fights when I don't have adequate loot. If it's possible, try to avoid fighting in the early game if you don't have a shotgun. The reality is, most of these early game fights are going to be close range, and pushing someone when you aren't prepared to take that fight is just bad decision making. Instead, you should use your knowledge of where other players are to loot safely until you are prepared to fight. Another common mistake I run into and I see other people face is they run out of mats in the early game. Running out of mats is a really big problem you can face, and it might even be worse than not having a shotgun, depending on the situation. So going along with this idea of preparing for fights, a rule I try to abide by is always farm around 200 mats before you take your first fight in the early game. Ideally, from this point, once you have a shotgun and you've gathered enough materials to fight, if your town has around 3 or 4 people, generally speaking what you want to do is wait for 2 players to fight and then come in afterwards to clean up. Now you aren't always going to be able to decide when you fight. Sometimes players are going to come at you and you'll have to respond. But coming back to that idea earlier, if you know where other people are in the town, you can put yourself in a spot where you are coming in after 2 people fight rather than somebody else coming in after you finish a fight. And that's going to give you a much better chance at leaving the first town and surviving the early game. Okay, that about covers it for how to approach the early game. Lastly though, I'd like to give a few quick tips for fighting that are specific to the early game. One thing you should always remember is that people usually won't have a lot of mats in the early game, so getting and retaining the high ground is really important, and it can actually provide much more of an advantage than it would in other stages of the game. A lot of the time, if you can get on top of a building, you'll have much better control of the town, and you'll be able to pick your fights. Another thing about the early game is you aren't always going to be able to get the guns you want, and that RNG factor might just screw you over sometimes, so whatever gun you get, make sure you are using it in its optimal setting. For example, if you loot a house and all you find is a bunch of assault rifles, what you probably don't want to do is go push somebody and force a close range fight. One last thing you should be aware of is that at the start of the game, there's going to be a wider range of skill, because people that generally aren't as good won't be killed off yet. So if it helps you, try to be confident and know that you have a better shot at surviving the early game than you do, say, winning a fight against a top 10 player. Alright, that is going to wrap things up for this video. Please do let me know if any of these tips helped you, or if there's something that I should have mentioned which I missed. As always, if you did find this video helpful, please do leave a like and consider subscribing. If you want to go above and beyond to help me, you can enter my supporter creator code in the Fortnite shop. It's SpookLuke, just like my YouTube username. Other than that, thanks for watching, and I'll see you all in the next one. Hate to break.